let's begin. It's the win. Listen, laugh, and learn, and understand. Hope, believe that you can. It's the Women's Information Network. It's the win.
Welcome to the Win Show. We're so glad you joined us. I'm Paula Fellingham, CEO of the Women's Information Network, thewinonline.com. We're the online home for all women, all ages, a community of women helping women live joyful lives filled with passion and purpose. Our hosts are Laura Lee Christensen, Executive Vice President of the Win, Suzanne Peterson, talented nurse and mother of four, and Kim Coles is an actress, comedian, author, and host. Our guest today is Brian Nelson Ford. He's an award-winning author and president of Eight Pillars Financial Education Company. He has a passion for teaching personal finance and helping you achieve greatness. Here's your financial greatness host and money expert right here, Brian Nelson Ford.
Yay, Brian.
Welcome.
So good to have you here.
It's good
Brian,
to be here.
I'm just curious how you decided to get into this field. It seems like it's a difficult one, especially these days in this economy. What made you decide to get into helping people with their money?
You know, I've always loved the subject of personal finance. I mean, even when I was in high school, I could pick up a book about personal finance and just devour it, even
really?
To this day.
Yeah. High school.
So my wife thinks I'm crazy, but I absolutely love the subject. But I think when it really hit me that this is what I wanted to do was when I made the connection of how our personal finances impact our personal lives, and more importantly, how it impacts our relationships. And that's when I knew that this is what I wanted to do. And you know, we know the divorce rate in this country is at 50%, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. We know that fights over money are one of the number one causes of the breakup. And so I view my company, my products, and even the Financial Greatness Show as the number one opportunity to save marriages and to improve relationships.
I love that connection.
Yeah.
It's such a whole connection.
Not very many people talk about relationships and money, but I love that you do because it's the key.
Yeah. I mean, I'm a numbers guy. I'm kind of the nerd. I love finance, but when it really comes down to it, it's how money affects our lives
That's
and our
true.
Personal relationships. Uh-huh. So.
That's so true. Yep.
Do you talk about these things in your newest book?
There we go.
There it is, The Eight Pillars of Financial Greatness. Here it is right here. Do you talk about that as well, these principles?
I do. That's what it's about. In fact, the Financial Greatness Show is based on the principles taught in my book. And what I'd like to, for a minute, is just have you visualize something.
Okay.
If you can.
We close our eyes?
So, don't need to close your eyes. But more than the show, I want you to visualize what it would be like to accomplish some of the principles that I'm going to discuss on the show.
Okay.
All right.
Imagine for a minute that you have a fully funded emergency account, 6 months of living expenses. What that would do for your relationship.
Absolutely.
Very nice.
What that would do for your life and how you would feel. What would it feel like to be completely free of consumer debt? To have a credit score of at least 720. How would it feel to be completely organized and have your financial goals on autopilot? Those are just some of the things that I talk about in my book and that I'll be covering on the Financial Greatness Show.
Well, it would be liberating.
I'm feeling
it'd
peace.
Be absolute peace. Freedom.
Freedom and peace.
And when we talk about that, everybody talks about financial freedom. Yeah. That's what it's about. When you don't have that pressure of
it lifts that burden.
Absolutely.
Is that what the financial peace account is all about?
Yeah. Pillar one is actually called establish a financial peace account. I call that financial peace account is because, you know, people don't want to hear emergency account.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And
that's
a lot of people think that emergencies in the future are so far off. Mm-hmm. But if an emergency never occurs in your life, for one, you're probably not human.
That's true.
But let's just imagine for a second an emergency never happened. Just by having that money in the bank.
Yeah.
Gives you an immense amount of peace. And some of my clients actually call it a save your marriage account.
Wow. I agree. I love that.
So how does what you do help women live better lives? You know, we're all about helping women. Helping women. Men helping women.
Sure. It's the Women's Information Network, but I'm excited. Hey, I've got two girls, by the way, and my two closest siblings are girls. Even my dog's a girl, so I'm very confident.
Qualified.
So I'm excited. But the goal of the Financial Greatness Show is to empower women to take back their financial lives. I mean, that's really what it's about.
I love it.
Money is an object to be managed. And financial greatness comes down to taking care of what you can control. Mm-hmm. And so you can't worry about those things that are outside of your control. Let's worry about those things you can. And most of those financial issues can be controlled. But also it's what we talked about. It's more about relationships. When couples are on the same page financially, a whole new dynamic comes into the relationship. Because money represents so much more than those little pieces of paper we carry around in our wallets.
That's true.
Money represents our deepest values. And when a couple's not on the same page financially, really they're not on the same page in life.
Yeah.
Because money represents our values, like I mentioned, and when you're on that same page and you're working towards the same goals, it makes a big difference. The dynamic completely changes. I mean, people go through my system and say, Brian, my marriage is completely better. I can't believe it. And I'm saying, are you sure I'm the finance guy. I'm not the marriage counselor guy.
So you're saying it's kind of an indicator you can look at. And if you're not in sync with each other on finances, then it may be indicative of other
levels of
for sure.
Disharmony.
Exactly.
And if you harmonize that, then it will affect.
It's exactly right. You're exactly right.
And I love that you mentioned your two little girls. You've written this darling book called Marshmallows and Bites. And I'd like to know, how did this come about?
Yeah.
Hold that book up a little longer.
Such a cute
Marshmallows and Bikes.
Huh? No, it's darling.
Look, my other book is fun, but I'm really excited about Marshmallows and Bikes. You know, book sales have been fantastic, which is always nice. I mean,
right, yeah.
I was just recognized with an Evie Award for the project, which is a decent literary award, which is fun. But the way it came about is actually pretty funny. It's based on a study conducted by Stanford in the 70s. Mm-hmm. And the study basically was, it's called the Marshmallow Study, and it was designed to teach children delayed gratification at an early age.
Oh, that's so cool.
I loved the study, so I started incorporating it into my parenting methods, and so I was trying to teach my girls delayed gratification, playing the marshmallow game with them, and then bringing it into real life with having them work and save for a bike. Mm-hmm. And while I was in the middle of doing this, I woke up in the middle of the night, 1 o'clock in the morning, and it hit me, strongest impression, go downstairs, go to your office, and write a book about what you're doing with your family.
Wow.
So
5 hours later, Marshmallows and Bikes was born.
5 hours?
So
are you kidding?
That's so inspirational, though. That's good.
It's fun.
That's just pure inspiration.
And just get it down and get it happen.
Yeah.
It's so important because I feel like our society today, everything's about instant gratification.
Yeah.
Kids don't know how to wait for something anymore.
And you could not write it that fast unless you had already lived it.
Yeah. It's fun.
True. And then you got your own instant gratification for yourself there.
You believe so strongly in it.
Well, the other book took me 2 years. That one took me 5 hours.
There you go.
It all evens out.
But yeah, my wife woke up that morning and I told her I wrote a children's book that night. And she thought I was joking. She didn't believe me.
Wow.
But it's fun. It's very, very gratifying because now I'm getting lots of emails from parents. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They're thanking me for teaching their children the importance of delayed gratification, of working hard, and of saving their money.
So
that's very rewarding for an author.
How young do you start with children? I mean, when you read this book to them, is it for
3-year-olds? Yeah, 3-, 4-, 5-year-olds can understand it.
Wow.
It's very simple. For the children that want to read the book themselves, more of the 7-, 8-year-old range. But what's fun is I've had even parents email me and say, I've got teenage children, and we've got the younger ones, and we read the book to the younger ones, but the teenagers are in the room, and they're always listening.
Sure, of course.
And it's funny, but because the book is called Marshmallows and Bikes, Teaching Children and Adults Personal Finance. Because the goal is, hopefully, when these parents and these teenagers are listening to the book or reading the book to their children, that the wheels are starting to turn, and they're realizing, sweetheart, maybe we should pay that credit card off and so forth. So
start with them with that one, and then go to this one.
Yeah, that's the advanced one.
We got you. Okay, we got you covered.
And catch a show on the
way. And I was just going to talk about the show. The Financial Greatness Show is the name of his show, and we are so looking forward to it. You know, it's time to close. We have loved being with you. Thank you so much. And thank you for joining us. We love being with you as well, and we invite you to visit thewinonline.com. where you'll get solutions and share ideas and really connect with women worldwide. Have a wonderful day and choose to live joyfully with passion and purpose.
It's the Women's Information Network. It's the Win.